Welcome back to my channel. So today I will be discussing about copper poisoning. In my previous videos I've discussed about lead, arsenic and mercury poisoning. If you haven't studied those, you may go. I have given their link in the description box. You can go have a look at them. Also, I'm going to upload a video, a short quiz on this metallic irritant series, where I'll be giving questions about arsenic, lead, mercury and copper poisoning. It will be a short quiz. You may go and attempt those and check your knowledge. How much have you gained? How much do you remember from all these videos? So today, copper poisoning. First, I'll be telling about introduction, then the toxic compounds of copper, action, how it works, acute poisoning and chronic poisoning, treatment and medico-legal aspects. So let's get started. First, introduction. Copper is a chemical element. Its symbol is Cu and atomic number is 29. It is soft, malleable, ductile metal with high thermal and electric conductivity. So a freshly exposed surface of copper is pinkish to orange in color. Copper is a metal that is non-poison. It is very important for the body for the normal functioning of certain proteins and enzymes like catalase, cytochrome C, oxidase, ceruloplasmin. Okay, so the body cannot synthesize copper on its own, so we need to take this from the diet that we have. Next, talking about toxic compounds of copper. First is copper sulfate or COSO4, blue vitriol, spelling mistake here, V-I-T-R-I-O-L, vitriol, also called blue stone. It looks like this. It is used in fungicide, algicide. It is used as fungicide, algicide, molluscicide. It acts as both as a poison as well as an antidote. The copper sulfate can cause acute poisoning as well. Also, it was being used as a precipitator in heavy metal poisoning, and it treats gastric and topical exposure to phosphorus. So it acts as an antidote also. Next is copper subacetate, also known as verdigris. It is frequently used in field of arts and external medicine. This is how it looks. Next is copper carbonate. It is used as fungicide. Basically, copper carbonate is a blue-green color compound forming part of verdigris. Copper carbonate looks like this. This is a picture that is showing verdigris. You can see bluish greenish color deposition on these copper metals. So this is what verdigris is. These are formed due to the reaction of copper with the air, oxidation process. This basically, if somehow it enters the body, it causes poisoning. Next, talking about the action, it affects the enzyme whose activity depends on sulfhydryl groups and amino groups, just like I told for arsenic, mercury and lead. Next, here copper also targets the nucleic acids. Copper oxide, it oxidizes the heme iron into methemoglobin, which causes cyanosis and chocolate brown color of the blood. Now talking about acute poisoning, symptoms are metallic taste, metal fume fever, hemolysis, hemoglobinuria. Hemoglobinuria means there's blood in the urine. Vomit is basically blue or green in color. Nausea, gastric pain, diarrhea. Fatal dose, if you talk about, copper subacetate is 15 grams and copper sulfate is 20 gram fatal dose. Now postmortem findings. Blue-green froth is seen around the mouth. Skin is yellow due to jaundice. Then the mucous membrane of the mouth and tongue may have bluish green tinge. Internally, there is discoloration of the mucous membrane of esophagus and mouth, and there is burn in esophagus. Superficial or deep ulcers are seen in the stomach and small intestine. Liver is fatty and soft. Now, chronic poisoning. There is green or purple lines that are seen around the gums. If you remember, green line was seen around in the gum area in lead poisoning also, which was called Burton's line or Burtonian line. Also, green color line is seen in mercury poisoning. Then there is metallic taste, nausea, vomit, diarrhea. These are some of the common features for all the metallic poisoning. Now, this bronze diabetes is seen in copper poisoning. Renal damage, copper dust may cause inflammation of conjunctiva and ulceration of cornea. Skin becomes jaundiced, yellowish color. Now, post-mortem findings of chronic poisoning. Liver is fatty and there is degeneration of epithelial cells in kidneys. Now, this is some important terms with respect to chronic poisoning of copper. First is chalcosis oculi. This is the deposition of the copper in the eyes, basically in areas like cornea, lens, vitreous humor and retina. Copper might get deposited in these. So this condition is called chalcosis oculi. The term chalcos, C-H-A-L-K-O-S, basically is a Greek term that means copper. So from there, chalcosis oculi, oculi eye. So this term has been made. Another is chalcosis corneae. Now in this cornea, there is a ring type formation is made in the cornea, which is near the decimens membrane adjacent to the limbus. This is the color of this ring is golden brown color. Like here you can see in this picture, this is a golden brown ring that has been formed. This is a normal eye wherein there is no as such ring. Here you can see the golden brown ring very clearly. This ring is known as Kayser-Fleischer ring. Another thing is chalcosis lentis, where there is opacity of the lens, that lens of our eyes. So basically a cataract is caused due to excessive amount of copper in the eye. Now it appears as small yellowish brown opacities in the subcapsular area of the lens. This is also known as subcapsular cataract or sunflower cataract, and it is yellowish brown or greenish in color. Now, vineyard spares lung. So what happened is that there is a solution called Bordeaux solution, which is 1-2% of copper sulfate solution with lime. This was used to spray on the vineyard by workers. Now those workers got exposed to this Bordeaux mixture, which has copper sulfate in it. Slowly they developed this copper chronic poisoning. So in this, the symptoms were interstitial pulmonary fibrosis and granulomas which contained copper. Now the treatment, of course we need to remove the people from the source of exposure. Then comes gastric lavage with 1% potassium ferrocyanide. Now when potassium ferrocyanide reacts with the copper present in our body, it gets converted into cupric ferrocyanide, and which is not harmful anymore. There is no need of emetics here because the vomiting will naturally occur in 5 to 10 minutes after ingestion. Also, emetics should be avoided to prevent re-exposure of the esophagus to the corrosive agent. Egg white or milk can be given as demulcents. Then comes chelating agent, BAL, EDTA, DMPS, DMSA. All these are good chelating agent that I have talked about for all the metallic poisons like mercury, arsenic, lead, and now this also. We need to maintain electrolyte and water balance. also symptomatic treatments have to be done accordingly. Now the medical legal aspects. Suicidal cases are rare. Accidental chronic toxicity may occur, like from eating food or from drinking water that is contaminated by verdigris. It may also occur in workers who are working in factory where some copper related products are being made. It may also develop from the wires that are used for intrauterine contraceptive measures. Then rarely it is used for any homicide because of its color, greenish color, and because of its metallic taste. So it cannot be used for homicide purposes. Alright, so this was all. If you found the content to be useful, then please like this video, comment if you have any problem or any question, and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.